Across the board, regardless of time, interest, or career, when people, students, choose a team or a school, it's because it feels right. And those state-of-the-art facilities help. It's not the brick and the mortar. It's the people that make it feel like home. And when you are surrounded by support and part of a much larger herd, good things happen. Go Bulls. You got a whole lot of love to give. You got a whole lot of love to give. You got a whole lot of love to give. You got a whole lot of love to give. You got a whole lot of love to give. You got a whole lot of love to give. You got a whole lot of love to give. You got a whole lot of love to give. Baby, gonna light the night. Gonna shine the light. Young Bulls gaining strides.
Guerrero on the drive.
Oh, and a big,
he
huge
did not
finish.
And young ladies building their conference resume. Yeah. This is USF Basketball. Run with the Bulls.
Diligence on who we recruit. Want to make sure, number one, they're great people. They're going to be great teammates, have great work ethic. We don't want to coach effort. And above all, they're unbelievable students, so we're not going to worry about a thing on that side.
I'm a sophomore, and my major is psychology. After I get my bachelor's degree, I want to study sports psychology because I want to help other athletes. Maybe I've been in their situations. I can help them. I can be something bigger than myself.
We have a standard. I guess the right fit, starting off academically, that's something that we don't want to deal with. If they're not serious about their schoolwork and they're not driven, and that side of things is not important, you know, we don't even deal with it. So it starts there. Another right fit would be what type of attitude and demeanor do they have? And work ethic and effort. How much do they love basketball? How good do they want to be? And how much basketball is important to them? So that's a huge part.
Good ball movement by the Bulls. Jesperson to the goal, lay it up and in. Laksa, she hits.
It's interesting when you go in the home and you meet parents. That also has a big play in it. Am I going to be able to communicate and deal with this young lady? And also some, and their parents, and that could be a red flag as well, because parents have changed over the years. And then you go into the basketball standpoint, okay, does this young lady fit our system, our style of play?
Yeah, kid's got it here. And guess what, just flare it on this side, flare it, now pin down.
Does she want to get better? How much room for improvement do they have? And then it all comes to play and how we're going to make them better, they're going to develop, and individually, they're going to get better, and our team collectively is going to be successful.
USF Basketball Run with the Bulls is brought to you by USF Health. USF Health, making life better. By Tampa General Hospital. Tampa General Hospital, live fiercely. And by Hooters. Hooters, get your game on. The original wing joint since 1983. And by Tico People's Gas, brought to you by the energy-saving conservation programs of Tico People's Gas.
USF. Oh, another one for Guerrero on the follow. Ruben Guerrero. I mentioned his nickname was Mr. Nice Guy. Earned the NCAA Sportsmanship Award last season and recognized across this campus.
Nobody could take that from Ruben. He deserves that. I was happy for him when he won that award. It's a great accomplishment for him.
I don't know, I just try to represent what my parents taught me when I was growing up. Just being respectful to everybody, coaches, players, referees, even the people that worked in the hotels, all that. I'm just trying to be nice to them because, I'm just trying to put myself in their shoes.
Thank you.
You too.
We're good. We get everything we want, so I'm just trying to be grateful for it.
I
Ruben is the type of guy that will dunk on you and then help you up. Like, so just, he's always such a good guy, and carries over to he's a hard-working guy, passionate guy. And he really cares about the team. He really cares about winning. You could tell he's passionate. He really wants to do something as well. So it's always great having a guy like him on the team.
And then the coaches, they're happy too, because that represents what they're teaching here, some of the values of USF men's basketball. So that's good that I'm showing that and that I've been rewarded for it.
Cunning basket. Oh! On the spot! And the foul! We have a one-possession game as everyone comes to their feet here in Memphis.
So I started playing basketball around 11, 12 years old. And first it was just for fun with a bunch of friends just playing in my hometown. But then I started liking it more and more, and it kind of became my life. And I think I was 14 maybe when I moved to the capital, and I started playing more seriously. That's when I started loving basketball, and that's when I think I knew that's what I wanted to do as a living.
And the big Spaniard gets the first points of the night.
Good patience and a good first possession for the Bulls.
Yeah, so USF, I don't know, it was my first visit, actually. So I don't know, I just landed here. My family came over with me, and I just like the vibe over here. I like the coaches, the way they treated me when I was visiting.
It's about balance. You gotta move your feet to catch. You ever heard that one before? You can't go get it without moving your feet.
I like the place a lot. I love the school, just walking around and on the little golf cart. I loved it, and then, I don't know, I kind of like saw myself coming here even before I visited the other two schools, so.
The Sandon's right there, so it's pretty convenient though. We got the dining hall right there, the Sandon right there, and my classes are all here. I got class right there, and that's it. So it's everything pretty close, I can walk everywhere. And it's always nice outside, so love it. Yeah.
Good pass, and Guerrero with the left. Room service.
I'm a junior now, so I'm trying to lead the team with a couple other guys like Troy and Bo. We've been here for the longest, so we're just trying to get the new guys on the same page and get the sophomores now, trying to get them a little bit more in the team. So we're just trying to tell them what to do, what's right.
We got better.
Base on three, 1, 2, 3.
Base.
Because we're actually together, we like each other so much. We like playing with each other, and we just gotta keep that going, because once we get it, we just gotta keep it, and that's what kinda makes it better.
A busy basketball weekend in the Big Easy starts right here. The American Conference on ESPN as Tulane looks for a season series sweep against South Florida. With Stephen Howard, I'm Wayne Rantazzo, and today we'll be showcasing two of the top scorers in the American Conference, led by South Florida's Gino Thorpe.
You're absolutely right, Wayne. Gino Thorpe is a Swiss Army knife for USF, top 10 in 5 categories in the American Conference. After coming back from injury 2 games ago, he's been on fire, averaging 19 points, 5.2 assists, and shooting over 47% from distance.
USF also just 1 conference win. It was recent, their last home game. They beat East Carolina. Nice move to the basket. Well, no finish for Tulio De Silva. The second try does fall, however, and De Silva gets USF on the board. Tulio De Silva, someone they love down in Tampa, the redshirt freshman, as De Silva gets an offensive rebound and scores for USF.
The Bulls' offense was struggling early when freshman Tulio De Silva would answer the call, scoring the team's first 8 points. In the second half, Gino Thorpe would chime in with a dominant 19 points.
Long 2 for Gino Thorpe. De Silva to Thorpe, and it's Thorpe with the finish. Gino Thorpe just around the free throw line with the jump shot. Thorpe looked for an opening and connects from 3. Gino Thorpe has made this a 12-point game. Thorpe now with 22.
However, it was the sophomore, Luis Santos, who would have the career performance with a perfect 7 of 7 from the floor for a career-high 16 points.
Jump shot rattles through for Luis Santos. after the Tulane mistake, and Bibby with the pass to Santos. Guerrero takes the jump shot, falls off. Great job by Santos, reaching for that rebound. Santos turns around and hits the jumper.
Even with a star-studded performance, the Green Wave proved to be too much for the Bulls.
Welcome to the University of Tulsa, site of tonight's American Conference basketball game with the South Florida Bulls in town taking on the Tulsa Golden Hurricane.
Coming into the game against Tulsa, the Bulls bitten by the injury bug, a plague that would affect them all game. But when your back is against the wall, you look to your stars to carry you through. Geno Thorpe would put on a show for the ages.
And it's tough three and splashdown for Geno Thorpe, the 35% three-point shooter who's averaged 20 in his last five. Eyes on me. I know the buzz when I'm fine. Here's Thorpe. He'll pull up. Nobody got him some space, and he gets the rope.
And I like the way Thorpe is playing because he knows he's the guy and he's being very calculating and searching out his offense, and he knows he has to have a big game for them to stay in the game and win the game.
That was a tough shot by Thorpe. He went off the Guerrero screen. Guerrero wasn't open and Thorpe had to pull up and take a shot he may not have been expecting to shoot. Come party with me. Pass intercepted by Bodway, playing a lot of minutes in this half. His pass to Thorpe was touched, deflected, and Thorpe skies for the layup.
Adding to the entertainment was the dunking clinics from Professor Ruben Guerrero.
Guerrero on the drive. Oh, and a big, huge finish. Guerrero, look at the pivot in the rocker step. And the elevation, get on my poster, son. Great job from the top. Nice, can you sign that? That was spectacular.
Even with an impressive comeback to tie the game, the injury bug seemed to trip up our Bulls against the Golden Hurricanes. As USF heads into the final games of the regular season, they know that improvements made now can carry over into next year. And they look forward to the experiences of playing in the conference tournament, something else that will carry over into successes in the future.
Something's got to give. Has 5 seconds to go. Jesperson, and yes!
The rematch against Temple was a guaranteed barn burner, with both teams battling for the number two spot in the conference as the regular season reaches its twilight. The Bulls were trailing most of the game, and they needed a hero. Maria Jesperson would answer the call.
With the drive by and the bucket to give him the lead.
The 22nd ranked Bulls said we came to play today.
And that's how you protect your home court.
Jesperson going hard. Jesperson has been like, I'm going in, and I'm gonna go hard.
Well, if you go back to January 29th, it was USF that led by as many as 16, and they were able to stave off a late rally and comeback from the Owls. Here, we're pitted in another great ball game as USF on a 10-1 run.
The battle from late January was in the back of everyone's mind, but this time, it would be Temple to shut the door on USF. The Owls would pull away late in the fourth, stealing a win on the road. The season series would end with one win apiece, with the hope of a rubber match in the conference tournament. The loss to Temple would put the Bulls in a pinch, with three games remaining in the season and two of them on the road. The Bulls would need to right the ship to try to take the second overall spot away from Temple. In times of need, you look to the seniors to find stability. You call upon their experience to help guide your team through trying times. As USF headed to the road, they would find their rock in Ariadna Pujol. The senior would bring her game to a new level, scoring 24 points and capturing her third career double-double. Her leadership sparked her teammates, pushing Kitija Laksa to a 24-point performance.
What you saying? What you telling me?
And Laia Flores flirted with a triple-double, falling just one rebound and assist short of the feat. The win against Houston would build momentum towards the matchup with Tulsa, routing the Golden Hurricanes by nearly 30 points. As March begins and the American Athletic Conference tournament looms, our Bulls head into the tournament poised for another appearance in the conference finals.
What you telling me?
USF Basketball Run with the Bulls is brought to you by USF Health. USF Health, making life better. By Tampa General Hospital. Tampa General Hospital, live fiercely. And by Hooters. Hooters, get your game on. The original wing joint since 1983. And by Tico People's Gas, brought to you by the energy-saving conservation programs of Tico People's Gas. This week's Painters on Demand Play in the Paint came in a big match against Houston when senior Ariadna Pujol finished with a career-high 14 rebounds. It is the senior's third career double-double and the second consecutive game with at least 10 rebounds. Her effort would help boast the Bulls over the Cougars 79-50.
You know, it doesn't matter how much basketball I know or the X's and O's or coaching or teaching. You know, if the kids don't truly care that you care about them, and what they're trying to accomplish, how's life outside of basketball, their parents, their siblings.
The kids will be 18 years old.
You gotta have a good balance. You gotta make sure that they feel comfortable that my door's open at any time that they can come in.
I think I'm
here.
Cool down three, 1, 2, 3.
Boss!
Hi, Coach Fernandez here with Kitija Laksa and Laia Flores, and we're gonna play Bean Boozled. Why don't you do the honors and spin the wheel?
No, coach, you're first. That's a good one.
Oh, good spin.
That's a good one. Are you for real? Blueberries?
Or no. Toothpaste? I got toothpaste, it's good. Oh. Ooh. Ha!
Dead fish. Tutti frutti and stinky socks. Oh, ooh, yeah. Oh, that's a stinky sock. Whoa, that's tutti frutti.
Oh my
nice.
God.
No.
We're killing this game. Juicy pear.
Ooh.
Booger.
Just eat it, fish.
I couldn't do it.
One of those, please.
Ooh, coconut spoiled milk. That's gonna be fun. Take water.
Why? I think we're done. Buttered popcorn rather than egg.
Strawberry banana smoothie dead fish.
Why is an M playing this? Right. I don't understand this. Okay, this is new.
Lawn clippings and lime.
I don't even know what. Oh, yeah, that's a grass.
But lawn clippings is easy.
For the win. It's good though. It's a good one. Yeah, it's a good one.
Congratulations. Thank you for tuning in and go Bulls.
Okay.
You're not spinning the wheel correctly. She got the same one.